Hello everyone, this is BSc third year linear algebra lecture. So today I am going to discuss what is meant by external direct sum and internal direct sum of a vector spaces. So what is meant by internal direct sum first? Internal direct sum. Internal direct sum of a subspaces of a vector space V. So consider definition. So consider V, capital V is a vector space over a field F. Over a field F. So consider a capital V is a vector space over a field F, and capital U1, capital U2, dot dot dot, capital N are subspaces of a vector space V. Are subspaces of a vector space, subspaces of a vector space V. So these are the subspaces U1, U2, dot dot dot, Vn are the subspaces of a vector space V. Then their internal direct sum is denoted by then their internal direct sum is denoted by U1 internal direct sum, U2 internal direct sum, E for internal direct sum, dot 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 dot, internal direct sum V1, internal direct sum V2, dot dot dot, internal direct sum Vn is denoted by like this. If every vector V belongs to capital V can be written uniquely, can be written uniquely such that U1 plus U2 dot 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 Uvn, where Ui belongs to capital Ui. So U1 belongs to capital Un, small U2 belongs to capital U2, dot dot dot, small Un belongs to capital Un. Each element of a vector space V can be uniquely written in this form. This is the first condition. And second, U1 intersection U2 intersection U3, dot 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 dot, intersection Un is nothing but singleton 0. And 0 is the only common element between these n subspaces. If this notation satisfies these two conditions, then we say that this is a external direct sum of a vectors of a subspaces U1, U2, dot 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 dot, Un. So understand the definition first. What is meant by internal direct sum? If V is a vector space and its subspaces, there are n subspaces. So n means any subspaces, 2 subspaces, 3 subspaces, U1, U2, dot dot dot, Vn are the subspaces of a vector space V. Then their internal direct sum is denoted by like this: Un direct sum in the base small e is, then U2 direct sum dot dot dot, internal direct sum Un. If this notation satisfies these two conditions, that is, every element of V can be written in the unique linear combination where alpha belongs to field F, which are 1, taken as 1, and their intersection must be 0. That is, the common element between these all subspaces should be 0, and no other element exists other than 0 in their intersection. If these satisfy two properties, then they called as internal direct sum. Now I am going to discuss what is meant by external direct sum. So this is about internal direct sum of a subspaces. Now external direct sum, there is a slight difference in between these two. Now external direct sum, external direct sum definition: if v1 v2 ... vn are n vector spaces over a field f, then their external direct sum, is denoted by v1 external direct sum, v2 external direct sum, vn. So the external direct sum of a vector space v1 v2 ... vn is denoted like this, or this can be denoted in other form: v1 cross v2 cross v3 ... cross vn. So these are the two methods to denote external direct sum of a vector spaces. If it satisfies, now v1 direct sum, v2 direct sum, ... direct sum, vn is nothing but it is n tuples v1 v2 ... vn, where vi belongs to capital Vi. So these are the n tuples. V1 belongs to capital V1, V2 belongs to capital V2, and Vn belongs to capital Vn. Then their addition and scalar multiplication is defined like this: if V1, V2, ... Vn and W1, W2, ... Wn. So these are the two elements of this set. Then their addition is defined like this: V1, V2, ... Vn plus W1, W2, Wn is nothing but V1 plus W1, V2 plus W2, ... Vn plus W1. So therefore the addition of these two vectors is defined like this, and scalar multiplication is defined: v1 v2 ... vn is nothing but alpha v1 alpha v2 ... alpha vn. So this is the external direct sum of a vector space v1 v2 ... vn over a field f. Now I am going to prove internal direct sum and external direct sum of a vector spaces are isomorphic. This is the theorem. Now I am going to prove these two are isomorphic over a field F, that is over a given field. F may be real numbers, F may be rational numbers, F may be any field. Now, our theorem, 4.1.2. The statement of the theorem is, if V is an internal direct sum of, if V is an internal direct sum of the vector spaces u1 u2 dot 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 un, if V is an internal direct sum of these n vector spaces, is isomorphic to the external direct sum, of u1 u2 dot 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 un, that we have to prove. If V is an internal direct sum of n vector spaces u1 u2 un is isomorphic to the external direct sum of u1 u2 dot 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 un, that is, we have to prove u1 external direct sum dot 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 external direct sum un is isomorphic to external direct sum u1 external direct sum u2 dot 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 external direct sum un. That is, the notation u1 external direct sum, u2 external direct sum, un, that we have to prove. Now, how we prove two vector spaces are isomorphic? We define one function and prove that this function is homomorphism 1 1 n and onto. If we prove these three things, then the two vector spaces are automatically isomorphic. So define a function f from v2 external direct sum of u1 u2 dot 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 un, that is, u1 external direct sum u2 external direct sum u3 external direct sum un. Define a function f from v2 external direct sum, where v is the internal direct sum of these vector spaces, where v is the internal direct sum of these vector spaces. Now, if v is the internal direct sum of these vector spaces, then every element of v can be uniquely written as in this form, u1 plus u2 dot 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 un, where ui belongs to, that we have discussed in the definition of internal direct sum. Now define the function f of v is nothing but u1 u2 dot 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 un, and this function is well defined because v has a unique representation in the vector space v, that is internal direct sum of u1 u2 dot 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 un. Hence, this function is well defined. Now we need to prove this function is homomorphism. We have to prove f is first homomorphism, second 1 1, and third 1 2. If we prove these three things, then the two vector spaces are automatically isomorphic to each other. Now first homomorphism, and we have proved earlier that this function, that is internal direction to external direction, is homomorphism. So no need to waste our time to prove this homomorphism. So I can directly write f is a homomorphism. F is a homomorphism. F is a homomorphism. Now I am going to prove this function is 1 1. Second, so take any two elements of internal direction, let u comma v belongs to v, and v is the internal direction of the vector spaces u1 u2 ... un. So u can be written as u1 plus u2 plus un, and v can be write v1 plus v2 plus vn, where ui belongs to capital UI and vi belongs to UI. So v1 belongs to un, u1, v2 belongs to u2 ... vn belongs to un. Now take f of u equal to f of v, and we need to prove u is equal to v. So f of u is now, u is what? u1 plus u2 ... plus un, and f of v is what? v1 plus v2 plus ... vn, and the function is defined like this: u1 u2 ... un. Hence the image of this element is u1 u2 un. This is nothing but v1 v2 vn. Now when the two elements of this are same, now if these two vectors are same, then we can write u1 equal to v1, u2 equal to v2 ... un equal to vn. This implies that u is nothing but v. This implies that f is 1 1. Now we need to prove f is onto, then automatically the two vector spaces are isomorphic. Now when the function is said to be onto, if the range set is nothing but codomain. So take any element for each w1 comma w2 comma wn belongs to u1 external direction, u2 external direction un, there exists unique element in V such that f of w1 plus w2 plus wn is nothing but w1 w2 wn. So for each element of a vector space, that is external direction of this vector space, there exists a unique element in V such that this happens. Therefore each element of a external direction of these vector spaces, there exists at least one element in the domain such that the image of this element is this. This implies that f is onto. So we can find a function f from the internal direction to external direction such that this function is a homomorphism, this function is onto, and this function is 1 1. Therefore these two vector spaces are isomorphic. Hence we can write u1 external direction, u2 external direction, internal direction un is isomorphic to u1 external direction, u2 external direction un. Hence the proof. proof. Hence the proof of this theorem. So this is the very important theorem, which says that the external direct sum and internal direct sum of the same vector spaces U1, U2, UN and these are isomorphic to each other. Now theorem 4.3.2. Theorem 4.3.2. The statement of theorem 4.3.2 is: if V is a finite dimensional and W is a subspace of V, if a vector space V is finite dimensional, and W is subspace of V. W is subspace of a vector space V. Then W dual, that is the dual space of W, is isomorphic to V dual upon annihilator of W, and VW and annihilator of W, and dimension of annihilator of W is nothing but dimension of V minus dimension of the subspace W, that we have to prove. Now, what is W dual? W dual is nothing but set of all homomorphisms from a subspace W to F. What is annihilator of W? A of W means F belongs to V dual, such that F of W is equal to 0 for all W belongs to the subspace W. And we know that A of W is a subspace of V dual. We know that A of W is subspace of V dual. Therefore, this implies that V dual upon A of W exists. This exists because A of W is a subspace of V dual. Now, we can prove the second thing, that and we also know that dimension of V by W is nothing but dimension of V minus dimension of W, where W is a subspace of V by W is a quotient space. Then dimension of V by W is nothing but dimension of V minus dimension of W. Also, we know that if V1 is isomorphic to V2, then dimension of V1 is nothing but dimension of V2. And we have given that W dual is isomorphic to V dual upon A of W. So take the dimension of these two sides, left hand side and right hand side. So dimension of W dual is equal to dimension of V dual upon A of W. We have know that if the two vector spaces are isomorphic, then their dimension is same. Now from this we can write dimension of V dual minus dimension of A of W. From this step we can write this step. So we got dimension of W dual is nothing but dimension of V dual minus dimension of annihilator of W, and we need to calculate the dimension of annihilator of W. So take to the left side and this to the right side. So dimension of annihilator of W is nothing but dimension of V dual minus dimension of W dual. Also we know that dimension of V dual is equal to dimension of V, and dimension of W dual is nothing but dimension of W. Hence we got dimension of annihilator of W is nothing but dimension of V minus dimension of W, because we know that dimension of V dual is nothing but dimension of V, and dimension of W dual is nothing but dimension of W. Hence the proof. So keep in mind that if we have to calculate the dimension of the annihilator, then use this formula, dimension of V minus dimension of W. That is, to find the dimension of annihilator of W, first find dimension of the vector space and then find dimension of its subspace, and then subtract the dimension of the subspace from a dimension of a vector space. Then we got the dimension of the annihilator of subspace W. So I am going to stop this lecture over here. So today I am going to discuss the corollary, that is tomorrow I am going to discuss annihilator of W is nothing but W. So thank you.